Here we have a variable scores, and we have 10 people on this variable. And notice here on this variable, the smallest value is a value of 6, and the highest value is a value of 10. To obtain a frequency distribution table on this variable, we want to go to Analyze, and then Descriptive Statistics, and then we'll select Frequencies. The Frequencies dialog box opens. We want to select the variable scores and move it over to the variables box by clicking on the right arrow button. And then really, that's about it for now. Click OK. And then the output window opens. And in the output, we see here our table scores. Notice that we have the scores, they're ordered from lowest to highest, so 6 through 10. And then in the next column, we have the frequency. So we can see here there's 3 values of 6, 1 value of 7, 3 values of 8, 1 value of 9, and 2 values of 10. We also have the percentage reported. So 30% of all of the values had a value of 6, or 6 occupied 30% of the data set, 9 represented 10% of the data set, and so forth. And then finally, we have the cumulative percent column, which may be of interest, particularly if you're in an introductory statistics course. In many frequency tables, you're asked to calculate the cumulative percentage. So if you are, that's what this column will do. And it tells you the percentage as it accumulates as you go to the top. So for example, this 100% here indicates that the values of 10 and below, so in other words, all of the values represent 100% of the data or of the values there. A 9 and below represents 80% of the values and so forth. And I'm not taking into account real limits here when I say that. So if that's of relevance to you, just make that note to yourself. Okay, now what if we wanted to have these values, say you wanted them to be in reverse order. Instead of from lowest to highest, you'd like it to be from highest to lowest. So instead of 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, we wanted, let's say, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Well, to do that, we'll just rerun our analysis. And we'll go to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, and then Frequencies. And here we'll select under Format, we're just going to select descending values. So go ahead and click on descending values, click continue, and then click OK. And here we see that we have now our values are in descending order. So 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. And then we see the frequencies here. And this table will agree with this table, of course, because we're looking at the same data. So we have 2 values of 10, 2 values of 10, and so on. The only thing is, when you order your values from highest to lowest, the cumulative percentages are reversed, and typically the cumulative percentage is read this way in this table, where 100% indicates the highest score. Notice it's reversed here. So keep that in mind if you do order your values from highest to lowest. This concludes the tutorial on obtaining frequency distribution tables in SPSS.